Tabua Oda East Federal Constituency. Mr. Speaker, I do agree that the fundamental objective directive principle of state is to provide some of the issues listed by this bill as enshrined in our constitution. But is it justiciable? That's the big question we have to ask ourselves. And I say no, because it's not justiciable. And the reason is, we've just taken a motion this morning, like my leader said. Unfortunately, I'm going to go the other way, because the motion we have taken is trying to work on food security. We are trying to make sure that there is no wastage during harvest season, and there is no lack during planting season. We haven't been able to put that in place, and if we have not been able to put that in place, how do we coordinate the implementation of food at state level and at federal level, like this bill is stating? The bill is stating that food should be made available both at the state and the federal level for everybody. How do we do that? How can we achieve that when right now we are talking about cold chain, we are talking about critical infrastructure for storage, silos, and all of that? So we have to take one step before the other. The first step to take is the motion we have taken this morning to put the infrastructure in place for storage facility, for processing, for packaging of our agri-produce. When we are able to put that in place, then we can start looking at this bill to provide food for everybody. I don't see how this bill can work when we don't have the critical infrastructure in the agri sector. Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. And I don't believe that we should take this bill, even if it is a Senate bill. What they are asking for is not justiciable. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.